Hello, everyone, and welcome to another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host, Richard Evans. Make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. Today, we dive further into the world of the 3Play 3P2 and how to trim the in and out points of your events. Now, when capturing instant replays, there may be times when you do capture the event, but you need to do just a bit of trimming on the in or the out point to make it flow a little bit better. A pretty simple and easy technique, but does require a little bit of explaining, so let me show you how it's done, son. All right, so here we are in the 3Play 3P2 interface. I'm not gonna do any clip capturing today. I just have this clip already in my clip list here. And let me go ahead and play that back first. So again, I'll have clip list selected on my A output, and let's hit my play button. And you'll see here's my clip getting towards the end, and whoop, looks like that clip stopped right before that ball went into the hoop there. So I want to change that by setting a new in and out point. So there's a way to do this within the control panel without having to go through and use the mouse and keyboard, all that jazz. And essentially what we need to do is on the control panel, we'll hold down the shift button, and this will allow us to move either before the endpoint or after the outpoint. All right, so I'll hold down shift and then I'll use my jog wheel here and start to turn it. And as you can see, I'm going past the outpoint. So let's just keep going a little bit and after it goes through. And let me go ahead and just let go to show you what happens now. If I just let go of it, I haven't set a new in or an out point. So if I hit play on that clip again, it's just gonna be the same clip because I haven't done anything yet. All right, so there we go. So now let's go ahead and change the out point. Again, well, by holding down the shift button and scrolling over here a little bit past it, now I can hit my set out button and also keep an eye on the interface as well. Let's go ahead and hit set out. All right, and now I have a new out point. You'll see that that has changed just a little bit on my interface here. So let's go ahead and play that clip. Let's go ahead and restart it. Here we go. So, got the pass. There's a shot. Boom, got it. So, now we have a new out point for that. Now, let's go ahead and also let me show you that you can do the same thing for the end point. So, for example, if I use my jog wheel and just keep jogging over here, it gets to that part and just doesn't do anything. All right, because we're at the end of it. So, if I hold shift, I can go backwards in time and grab the whole play here. So, we can start here and set my end point. All right, so now that has changed that clip again. And let's go ahead and hit play. Keep the eye on the A output, and now you see I have a new endpoint, and the out point is secure where it needs to be. Boom, done, pretty cool. All right, so next thing I wanna do is I'm gonna add this clip to my playlist so I can make a highlight reel for, you know, like a commercial break, et cetera, et cetera. So to do that, I have my angle selected here, which is camera 4, I like that one. So I'll hit add to playlist here, and when I do that, boop, there goes my clip. It is now in here. All right, so let's go ahead and I'll switch to playlist mode, and let's hit play on that. And again, it has the same in and out points that I've altered up here on the clip list. All right, but since this is for a highlight reel, I wanna make it a little bit quicker. So let's do this. I'm going to scroll backwards. I'm not gonna go too far back in time, maybe just to here when he passes the ball. All right, so now from here, I'll do the same thing. I'll hold down shift, set my endpoint. Boom, there we go. Now I have a much smaller clip. Let's go ahead and play it back. And there it is, short clip. Good to go. Sweet. So whenever you do a change over in any of these sections, so if you make a change here or here, they will not affect the other unless you're adding that clip to the, you know, playlist, etc. So just keep that in mind when you're moving forward. Again, a really cool and fast way to edit your clips on the fly without having to do any, you know, complicated actions within the 3Play, and all from this lovely control panel. So again, dive in and have some fun. So another great use of the 3Play control panel for keeping your shows flowing nicely. Again, you can use this technique either in the clip list for instant replays or in your playlist for melt or highlight reels. It's really up to you. I'll be steadily going through additional features of the 3Play 3P2 in upcoming videos, so make sure that you subscribe to our YouTube page, which you can find at youtube.com/newtechinc. So we know these videos are pretty cool, but if you're looking for more training resources, I also highly recommend checking out New Tech University, which you can find more information about at newtech.com/newtech-u. And if you'd like to know even more about New Tech products and services, contact your local reseller or visit newtech.com/demo, where you can sign up for a free New Tech product demonstration. And lastly, if you are posting your work on social media, please tag us using the hashtags NewTech, TriCaster, or 3Play. I see all of you out there working hard and creating some cool stuff, so keep it up. And thank you so much for watching. I hope that these videos are helpful to you, and I'll see you again soon for another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials.